Okay, continuing off where we left off, user preferences. This is basically a whole training session into itself because of the amount of information that is in here. When you're doing your user preferences, this lets you set your PowerMaster up to define your recommendations and your specifications for your testing. It gives you options such as error accuracies, how far do you want it to be out of error tolerance before you declare that it's a failure, how it calculates power, etc. The first couple options are your test error limits. Now typically, you're going to leave your meter at 1x. That means if it's a plus or minus 0.2% meter, if it is outside that tolerance, it will declare a fail. With your CTs and your PTs, I always start those off at 3x specifications. The reason behind that being your CTs are rated for 0.3% accuracy at 100% load, 0.6% at 99% load to 10% load, and then below 10% of rated load, there is really no accuracy specifications. It can be whatever it wants to be at that range. 3x gives you a little bit of a leeway to accommodate for burden, for harmonics, for load changes, for non-sinusoidal waveforms, and it will allow you to give also a little bit of leeway as far as your positioning of your primary CT, the flex rings, or the high voltage light wire probe. So by putting these at 3x, it gives you a little bit. If you want to change that, feel free to go in and change it to whatever you want. There is actually a user-specified setting. So you can actually set it to whatever you truly wish. Same thing for your PTs. The next section down, save additional data after meter test, meter trend data, waveforms, and harmonics. You can choose to save these, and after all your meter tests, this data will be saved and sent back over with your data files to the meter site manager. The benefits to doing this is if you have problems with a meter, you can actually get a look at the power quality environment and determine if maybe that meter's too old to handle that type of environment. Demand test options allows you to set up your options for your demand testing. 5-minute intervals, 15-minute intervals, demand sum, demand average, or energy. Harmonic limits, you can actually save up to the 50th. And the minimum threshold is percent, that is the percent THD per that harmonic component. So at 0.01%, that means if the third harmonic is greater than 0.01% THD, it will record it. If it's not, it will not. That's a nice safe area to start out at. The second page, accessed by pressing F2, is your measurement settings. This is how the PowerMaster will do your measurements. The default is the frequency domain, which is an FFT, or a fast Fourier transform, and that includes the fundamentals and the harmonic values when doing the calculations. It's the most accurate way to get an accurate reading. Fundamental just returns the fundamental value from that FFT, and time domain is every 60 hertz, every cycle. It will calculate that cycle and give you an RMS value. Each one can be changed individually, or they can all be changed by the function keys at the bottom. Next page, this is just a few little additional options. You can have a default pulse output from the 3 series with a additional B and C type connector, and you can set your output case of H here. General settings, language, English. Pause after each test. Keep that checked. If not, it's just going to pretty much stream through your test. You won't be able to really examine your results or check anything. It just runs them and does them for you. Audio feedback, meter beat volume, interval time base, those are all adjustable. Backlight, that is how long the display is going to stay on without user interface. CT, display parallelogram absolute data. Without getting into a great discussion about parallelograms, that's how you view your CT results. You can do it absolute data or with reference to zero burden. I prefer absolute data. It's more accurate, more easy to read, more easy to understand. And then the IEEE accuracy parallelogram, you can either view it at that, which would be 0.3 and 0.6. Your user defined, in this case, was 3x, so it's 0.9 and 1.8, or both. The greater your user defined is, the further apart that becomes from the IEEE, and the harder it is to really read it. So in this case, I'm always going to go ahead and assume we're going to go to the user defined. So we drop down menu, select user defined, and drop down menu again. And enable pass-fail. If you uncheck that, it will not return a pass-fail. You will have to make that determination upon yourself. The next page is display preferences, where you can go between ANSI or IEC viewing mode, which would be between current in front of voltage, voltage leading current, 60 to 50 hertz, horizontal versus vertical in your vectors, percent accuracy would be registration versus plus or minus percent error, ohms versus VA, case of T versus impulses per kilowatt hour, and nameplate ratio of 5 instead of 1. This allows you to make all these little changes in here that are, once again, specific for you. They do not affect your test or your test results. The next page, this gives you to create custom fields for test sessions. If there is information or data there that we do not have that you wish to collect, you can create your own custom field. Kilowatts as found, kilowatts as left, stuff like that. You name it, and then you have the option to input that data later. There is a couple of pages of these. Load box codes does not apply to the 3 series because the 3 series does not have a load box. And then we have custom fields for site description, which would allow you to do any more description naming that you may want that we do not already have in there, such as you can change it to be locator ID, you can put GPS coordinates, change a transformer number, anything that's a little bit extra you may want that we didn't have an option for. You can now create that on field. And that finishes up your user preferences. Once you're done, F6 save. And then it returns you back to the previous menu. And we'll go ahead and go back out to the main menu. And we'll get ready to start the next video, which is your sites.